the body's crap, mate.
Simon out of the board, A-hole here.
Thank you so much for joining me once again. Obviously, I'm wearing a vest because I have to push out there the image. Oh, I'm really big and jacked. Otherwise, you may not believe the things that I'm telling you. I've got a video one day talking about all of that kind of stuff. Like when you go into Gap, you don't buy extra large, you don't buy large. You look around and you pick up the medium. Or when you're bulking, you wear a jumper because you know it's going to make you look bigger. Don't pretend you don't do it. Talk about kind of crazy things that kind of defy logic, because why wouldn't you buy the correct shirt size for you? I mean, that mystifies your mind. There are a bunch of stuff that happen when you go to the gym or when you're in the gym or when you get into this fitness lifestyle that if you actually kind of back off a little bit, it defies logic. You break logic, which is effectively, you know, destroying science, and everybody says that's not a thing. So yeah, sit yourself down, get yourself ready, because these are 10 gym things that utterly destroy logic. Number 10 is the differing weight problem. Now look, I understand why this does happen like this, because there is no going back to its science when it comes to lifting weights in terms of what your body is going to do some days and what it's not going to do others. But don't pretend this happened hasn't to you, right? Don't pretend, much like you picking out smaller tops when you go clothes shopping. You sit down to do leg extensions, right? You're going to do leg extensions and you're going to do single leg ones. And amazing, you look down, you're like, wow, I'm doing 50 kilograms on each leg. So you think, surely I can do 100 kilograms on both legs, and you try to do it, and you can't. And it actually turns out that you can only do 80 kilogram on both, but you can do 50 kilogram on singular ones. What does that say about you? What the hell is going on? You wouldn't be able to teach that in a class. That's like sitting down, that's like you being the math teacher in a class and going 2 + 2 = spaghetti. Every kid is going to be like, what do you mean 2 + 2 = spaghetti? And then you've got to come up with some kangfoogled explanation about how it does make sense. This happens to me all the time. Happens to me all the time. What's even worse is when you go to different gyms and that says 50 kilograms, and you try and lift it, but it's a different kind of 50 kilograms. Because secretly, you know, some gyms actually, they say it's 50, but it's more like 42.5. So when you go to their gyms, you feel stronger and you think, oh, maybe I should subscribe here. That's a true tale. Number 9 is a kind of similar thing. At 9 a.m, you look great. And you go back to the mirror at 10 a.m. and you look terrible. What the hell happened? What did you do? I'm not saying you've eaten. I'm not saying you've drunk. I'm saying literally at 9 a.m. you catch yourself in the mirror. You're like, hey, look at that, looking really jacked there, friend. And then you go back an hour later without consuming anything and you look bloated and you look a bit fat and you don't look lean and you don't look as big and there's no explanation. Now, obviously what's happening here is your brain is playing tricks on you. That's what a brain does. In fact, sometimes, this is true, this is what sometimes people do, because they look at themselves and go, wow, I look really good. Next time, they will sort of demote that a little bit in their head because they actually feel quite guilty that they were nice to themselves. It's true. Sometimes people will just do backflips not to be happy because being happy is quite scary, right? Of course it is. Like, what, I'm happy now? Oh, something bad's about to happen. But still, it's the worst thing when you're training in the gym. In general, you go to the gym or you're a fitness freak. Because you kind of go through the last 60 minutes. Did I say something to the wrong person? Am I about to die? There's no answer. That's just what happens. Number 8, again, similar kind of thing. One day in the gym, you're Superman, and the next day, you're the Riddler. And let's face it, the Riddler don't lift that much weight. Like, he's really smart, and he could probably figure out a way to kill you, but this guy's never done a squat in his life. Not being a hater, I'm just calling it like I see it, whereas Superman, I mean, genuinely, Superman probably has the best physique of all time. How he actually lifts weights, I don't know. Because he has super strength, what the hell does he have to bench or curl to get to the level of resistance where his muscles actually, let's not even worry about it, that's a different video for a different time. But isn't it such a crazy thing? You know, you can go to the gym on a Monday and you do push, and you're like, flipping hell, I was so strong, I was awesome, you do like 100 kilogram bench or whatever. The next Monday, you're so pumped, you're like, man, it's gonna be so good like last week, and you go to list the same thing, and it's literally like, it sounds like you're trying to give birth and you're not. You're in a public place and nobody wants to see it. It is utterly, utterly baffling. And then it destroys your confidence. It destroys it. And look, it can be one of many things. It can be that you didn't get enough sleep. Maybe you accidentally, not accidentally, but maybe you didn't eat enough that day or you ate more the day before. You went at a more optimum time given the calories that you had. It can be a thousand things. Maybe you had more pre-workout and you didn't realize that you'd overscoop. Like, there's so many little things that can change it. But it doesn't mean that in your world, and obviously everything's in your world because you're you and I'm me, in your world, it's like, well, this should just destroy the very foundations of what I built my life on. If I can lift 100 kilograms there and I've had another week of progression and evolution, why now am I struggling with 80? Number 7 is getting annoyed at your own body parts, right? You're getting annoyed. You look at yourself in the mirror, the mirrors are back again, the reflection. The gym goes in the mirror is a toxic relationship. And you look at your deltoid and you're like, man, that is a crappy deltoid. A crappy shoulder, rubbish. It's what you start doing, like giving you lateral raises and military presses and who knows what else. Look at you, rubbish. Who do you think is going to happen? You think the deltoid's going to hear it and, oh, my feelings hurt, and grow? No, you just don't drag yourself down. Look, if you really get into the nitty-gritty with each one of your muscle groups, of course some are going to be better than others. I had to go for a physical exam the other day, a general checkup the other day, as you do, once a year I go. The doctor, Mother Hubbard, was all like, oh, well, your right pelvis is clearly bigger than your left. I was like, shut up, dude. I work really hard. What do you know? Who you are? Mr. Olympia judge? And then he asked me to leave because he thought I was being quite rude. But you are never going to be perfectly symmetrical. Even if you go look at the super duper pro bodybuilders that are pretty much, I mean, right on point. If you want to get right into it, you can see, oh, that's a little bit overdeveloped, that's a little bit underdeveloped. But we do. We stand there and point and criticize ourselves as if it's going to light a fire under us. Number six is even worse. It's other gym people yelling at you. I know I've gone on about this before, but I'll go on it ever again. If I'm ever in shorts on a video, Simon, your calves are really rubbish. What do you want me to do about it? More importantly, what do you want to do about it? Aren't you just happy that I'm in the gym and I'm trying to develop myself and I'm in competition with myself and I'm trying to get better? No, you want to tell me that my calves are bad. I know my calves are bad. Not that even bad, I train them as hard as I possibly can. I don't get good development down there. Could I try something new? Probably, but I'm quite content with my life. It's baffling. We should all be in the BLC, the big little club. I told you before, I'll tell you again. Doesn't matter if you're big, doesn't matter if you're little. We're all in the same club. You do your own thing. Nobody should be able to try to drag you down. Now, I understand it's coming from a place of lack of self-worth from the person that is shouting at you, but it still doesn't make it any more baffling. You should be going, man, Simon, even though your calves aren't great, look at those cracking lats. And I'd be like, oh, yes, sweet, I got cracking lats. But we don't. We just go, look at your wank calves. Number five is that some days you hate going to the gym, right? You hate it. You go Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, but then Sunday you're like, I don't want to go to the gym. And yet you still go. Now, I massively respect it. I've said it time and time again. Obviously, you need rest days too. But some days, the best workouts you can have is when you don't want to go, but you motivate yourself to get there, and you power through. But you would never go sit in the cinema if you didn't want to be there, would you? You wouldn't go bowling. Do you want to go bowling? Oh, I guess so. And you're just like rolling bowls, down 10-pin bowling. Oh, I can't believe it. I got a strike. I got a spare. Or in the cinema eating popcorn. Like, don't even like this movie. You would just go and do something else. But that's not how it works with the gym. The gym is also a bit, it's like, I don't know, some kind of like prison. Where you have to serve your time, which I guess is kind of true in many ways. It cracks me up. Number four is that it underpins everything. It is the foundations to your life. And it doesn't really destroy logic, but nothing should sit on your shoulders like this does. But I mean, doesn't it? You can be out and you're thinking about, when can I get my meal in? How am I going to miss a meal? How am I going to get enough protein? How am I going to get to the gym? I've got all these plans. And every single day you wake up, you have goals. And you have a routine because you have to get your 5-6 meals in. You've got to get to the gym. You've got to do your cardio. You've got to get your water in. And life will try and get in the way, but it underpins everything. It's always there hanging around. And some days you aren't able, Gerald, some days you aren't able to do all of this. And you get to the end of the night, you're like, man, it's terrible to do that. I made a mistake. No, you didn't. It's fantastic that you had the goal to do it in the first place, but you can't expect to smash it every day unless, of course, you're doing it professionally and you're being funded to do it, because then you have the time and you have the money and you have the finances. Massively privileged position if you're in it. Hell yeah, I massively support you. But it's going to be the minority compared to most. I do it more than anything. Like, I wake up in the morning, go do cardio. Got to get breakfast in. We've got to go to the gym before I even think about anything else. And that is every single day. And it's been that way for 20 years. Nothing else has been in my life for 20 years other than me. So I was born, poof, there I am. And the other determinating factor about myself is gymming. Number three is the sheer juxtaposition, or whatever you want to call, the antithesis to what we try and achieve. We want to be big, so we eat a load and we get fat. And then we want to get fat, you know what I mean? That we carry more body fat. And then we want to go the other way, so we lose all that fat we've just built. It's great. There are so many other, well, there are so few other things where you can apply that kind of nuts logic. What are you going to do now? Well, I'm going to eat loads for 6 months and just put on size. Then what are you going to do? Well, I'm going to lose all that bulk I put on and see what's what. I know there's more to it than that, but when you break it right down, it is the greatest thing ever. I don't know who came up with it, but I want to give them a medal. Number two are squats. That destroys logic. Squats is the equivalent of leaving your house, or standing outside your house, getting Google Maps and Google mapping to your home, and then turn around and stepping back in, and then saying, home, You didn't go anywhere. That's what a squat is. Actually, it's different to that. It's like standing outside your house, putting an insane amount of weight on your shoulders and then going back in your house. That's what squats are. Where are you going to go? Down? Where are you going to come now? Back up? Do you have a good time? Not particularly. And number one is how detrimental some people, me included, that's why I'm saying it, are in the gym. You could lift a house. You could deadlift a house and you sit down after the set is done and you go, yeah, it wasn't enough. It wasn't enough. A house. A house. You deadlifted a house. If you put that on YouTube, you're going to at least do 1 million views. I promise you. Then you're going to be upset about the revenue. But again, another video for another day. I love it so, so much. And everybody, apart from the super arrogant gym bros, and hell yeah, good for them. You go and smash it. But the general gym person that I meet, oh, you know, what's your max bench? And they'll go, 120. It's not that great. In your head, you should always be lifting more. Now, on the one hand, fantastic. It's a great motivator and it's a great way to keep you going. But two, give yourself a pat on the back. Even if right now you're lifting 20 kilograms on the bench, but last week you were only doing 15, that is a huge increase. 5 kilograms? I know 5 kilograms again in gym bro world is like, oh, five kilograms. Like, do you really? If you do, you need to go see a doctor. In the gym world, putting 5 kilograms on is awesome. Do it like this, right? You were doing 15, so 5, 10, 15. Add another one. You've just put on a third of what you were doing. Like, that's huge. It's absolutely massive. But by the time you do get to 50, 60, 70, 80, you should really be having a party. Do you know what it's a lot like? Not the best example in the world. It's a lot like YouTube, but it's true. When you first start on YouTube, you get 100 views. You're like, shit, 100 people have watched my videos. And then maybe if you're lucky, it goes 1,000, 2,000, 5,000. You get to 10,000 people, 10,000. If you were in any kind of entertainment industry and you were selling out 10,000 buildings constantly, you would be a massive success and you would be in demand. On YouTube, you go through this process, and then you're like, oh, some other people doing 50,000. And you just want more and more and more and more. And that's because the numbers become irrelevant. Because you cut, and it's the same with the gym. The numbers soon to become irrelevant. And if you don't sort of make these huge leaps that you've met before, you don't feel like you're getting anywhere, but it's not true. The fact that you're going and the fact that you're trying to achieve progressive overload is the most important thing. And don't forget, progressive overload can be increased in weight. It can be an increase in sets. Really, it can be better form. It's not really, it kind of fits in, but kind of doesn't. But let's say you do 8 reps of bicep curls, and your 8 reps of bicep curls a week later, you know you've hit with better form and better time under tension. I consider that progressive overload because you've trained your body better. And that's all progressive overload means. Train your body better than you did last time. I don't want to step on Greg Doucette's toes here. It's not what I'm trying to do. But the message can be that simple. So basically, don't beat yourself up. There you go, 10 gym things that absolutely destroy all logic. And I'm going to bet that everyone watching has at least experienced 5. And if you haven't, you're a brand new gym goer. Don't worry, you'll have to go through this hell soon. Like the video, share the video, subscribe, hit the bell, ding, ding, so you know when other videos were going live. It's like a notification wagon. It's a good thing. There's another video on screen. Give it a click. Patreon.com/Simon316 if you want some rewards. There's postcards, t-shirts, all bunch of nonsense. You can check it out. As Simon316 on Instagram and Twitter. Go in the link below there. There's merchandise too. Otherwise, you take care of yourselves, and me and Gerald, the fitness mascot, we'll see you soon.